Let's play a fun game of real or Doctor Who alien. Creatures that eat electricity. Yeah, those are totally real. Hi everyone, Julian here for DNews. Some people live to eat. I eat to live. Seriously, the idea that I have to feed this stupid body every day until I die sounds exhausting. I wish I could just plug into a wall, charge overnight, and go about my day. Now, of course, that's not how things work. Everyone needs food, and I should be grateful that I get it because it's game over if I don't. If you remember high school biology, it all has to do with cellular respiration. Your cells break down glucose from the food, runs it through a three-step process, and by the end of it, you get the energy your cells need to do work in the form of adenosine triphosphate, or ATP. The last step of that process, oxidative phosphorylation, is the real moneymaker. Basically, electrons are transported down a chain and eventually combine with oxygen. The process forces protons across a membrane, and in order to normalize the electrochemical gradient, the protons travel back through a pump that generates tons of ATP. That's also why you need to breathe. Without the oxygen, the electrons have nowhere to go, and you die. Side note, cyanide kills you because it keeps oxygen and electrons from combining, and you die. So, not enough oxygen or too much cyanide, and your cells run out of energy and starve themselves, and you die. Isn't learning fun? Anyway, some bacteria decided that the first two steps of cellular respiration were for chumps and cut straight to the good part. They literally absorb electrons from the surrounding rocks or metals and use them to create ATP. In a sense, they're eating electricity. And they may be more common than you think. It's not that we've found just one species of electric bugs, but thus far, at least two genera have been discovered, Shewanella and Geobacter. And they have some interesting practical uses. By making electrons flow, they generate a current, so it's possible they could be used as a living fuel cell. Some Geobacter species can be also used for cleaning up the environment. For example, one species can clean groundwater contaminated with uranium by using the uranium ion as an electron acceptor. This changes it from a form that dissolves easily in water to one that doesn't. The uranium falls out of the water, and all you have to do is scoop it up, albeit with some nice thick gloves on. These bacteria can also give us new ideas of what life can look like and the bare minimum amount of energy needed to sustain it. So when we're scouring alien worlds, maybe we'll put some electrodes in the ground and see if anybody shows up for dinner. Speaking of scouring alien worlds, the internet is a big crazy place and you can create your own right there on the web. And no domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name from domain.com. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. In the search for extraterrestrial life, bacteria is probably your best bet because everything down here on Earth is just loaded with the stuff. Everything. If you want to become a germaphobe, check out Julia's video here.
Bacteria is everywhere, literally, in the ground, on the subway, in and on your body. I mean, we are mostly made up of bacteria. There's more of them than there are of us. For every one of our cells, there's 10 bacterial cells.
What's the strangest life form you've heard of? Want us to do a video on it? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on DNews.